Mechanized Series. Episode 8. Panzerkampfwagen 5, or better known as the Panther. The Panzerkampfwagen 5 Panther was a response to the T-34. According to the German classification, the Panzerkampfwagen 5 was a medium tank, although judging by its weight, over 40 tons, and armor protection, it was really a heavy tank. This confusion was due to the fact that the Wehrmacht's classification of tanks was based on the gun caliber rather than the tank weight. Development of the Panzerkampfwagen 5 started in 1941, with two companies, namely Daimler-Benz and Mann, participating in the contest. The tank designed by Daimler-Benz copied the T-34 in many aspects, including appearance and layout. Mann, on the other hand, developed a typical German-style design, with the engine in the rear and transmission and drive wheels in the front. The Mann prototype was finally chosen, improved, and put into mass production under the designation Panzerkampfwagen 5 Panther as Ausführung D. In March 1944, production of the Panzerkampfwagen 5 Ausführung G, the most popular Panther model, began. The hull was redesigned, the driver's hatch was removed from the front armor plate. The driver's and radio operator's hatches were hinged and reshaped. The hull armor became thicker and the side armor plates were installed at sloped angles. The vehicles produced after November 1944 had a reshaped gun mantlet, modified armor protection for the exhaust pipes, which incorporated flash suppressors as well, and a fan above the engine compartment. A total of 2,953 Panzerkampfwagen 5 Ausführung G tanks were produced. From late 1944 to 1945, some tanks were equipped with the FG-1250 infrared searchlights. The Panzerkampfwagen 5 is considered to be one of the best German tanks during the Second World War, and rightly so. Combining powerful armor and armament with pretty good maneuverability, the Panther was a menacing opponent. It should not be implied that the Panzerkampfwagen 5 had no weaknesses. Its Achilles heel was the running gear, which provided for smooth movement but turned out to be the most unreliable part. The running gear accounted for almost half of all mechanical damage, with engine problems ranking second. This was mostly due to the tank's excessive weight. According to the armor layout, the front plates were the thickest, 80mm for the hull and 110mm for the turret, while the sides were only 40mm thick, which was thinner than the armor of the T-34. Also, the quality of the German steel began to decrease sharply after mid-1944, which negatively affected armor protection. At the same time, the Panzerkampfwagen 5 had at least one unquestionable advantage over enemy tanks: the 75mm cannon 42L-70 gun, that can penetrate 89mm of armor at a range of 2 km. And that is a brief summary of the Panther tank. If you enjoy this content, make sure you're already subscribed. Until next time, chaps.